Let it snow, let it snow, let it snow.
On your mark.
Basically, what you're trying to say is that you can't control it.
I'm not trying to say that. The whole bloody ship is.
It's the wild color scheme that freaks me. I mean, when you try and operate one of these weird black controls, which a lady can brighten up with the background, a small black light lights up black to let you know you've done it. What is this? Some kind of intergalactic light? What?
Well, looky here, Hal, what do we have?
Does anybody want coffee?
Hello and happy Friday. I think some people misunderstood when I said I was going to get myself a quick coffee. I meant for me. I'm not a barista. I wasn't taking orders, but good to see you anyway, Booyah Grandma. Thanks for stopping by. So something a little bit different today. We're not going to be working on the usual Madister X. Welcome in. We're going to be working on Homeward Hound, as it has, well, hopefully become the new norm. We're going to be working on a zombie game. But what we don't have is an automatically updating stream title. So we're probably going to look at that first to make sure that on Fridays... Does anybody want coffee? I do. Look, I've got a coffee in my extra coffee for 2 minutes Irish John mug. Yeah, so we're going to be working on zombies. We're going to look at setting the title automatically because Mondays and Wednesdays...
Wanted, Bit.ly the kid. $100,000 reward for his capture.
Mate, we've talked about this. It doesn't matter how many times you tried to catch me, I always escape. Thank you for that
multi-ball. Can't see me now
anyway. Oh, there I am. Okay. So, since
get hyped
I...
for
Dukasoft. There you go. Dukasoft is a sub. So, since I stream Mondays and Wednesdays, Homeward Hound, and Fridays will be Zombies, on the as-yet untitled zombie game, then I need to set the title accordingly. So on the last stream, we had some code that determined what day of the week it was, so that we could put a message on the ending stream theme. And so we'll use the same code today to determine if it's a Monday or a Wednesday. Then we'll set the stream title to be Homeward Hound. If it's a Friday, we'll set it to be Zombies. How about that? What do you think of them apples? Okay. What's Billy saying? Oh, God, the horn scared me. Almost made beans. Horn? Which horn? Did I miss a horn? Oh, the... confetti cannons for the who subs command. Let's see if it works manually typing it.
Get hyped for Nerduino.
Yeah!
Congratulations.
Wait.
Bit.ly the kid was caught.
No.
$100,000 for you.
Excuse me. Hello. No.
Okay, well, at least the randomizer works, and 20% of the time I do get caught, so well done, Berlin. Looks like you're in the money today. Okay, so yeah, we're going to automatically update the title. Pixels to paper!
Happy New Year!
Pew, 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 pew! Thank you for that redemption. Good to see you. How are you keeping well? Okay, so yeah, we're going to look at automatically updating the stream title. I'm not really sure what it is at the moment. I'm going to have to go into my other browser, doing the best I can. Well, I'm glad to hear it. And if there's anything I can do to help, you know where to find me. So let me just see if I can get to the creator dashboard. Maybe, possibly, potentially. On the creator dashboard, I'll be able to see what my title currently is and see what we can change it to. All right, so the default, which is pretty much the same for every stream now, if it ever comes up, here we go. Okay, so the title we have, you should see an icon or an emote of a dog. It should say Unity Game Dev, Homeward Hound, Drop, Merch Snow. Okay, So let me take a copy of that. And that can be for Monday and Wednesday. Actually, all we need to know is we need to say if it's not a Friday. So not Friday title, and then we need a Friday title. Okay, that should work. Brains, more like coding, live game, deck. Okay, all right, so the Friday title we'll be having. In fact, I want to get into the deeper into the brains, so to speak. So I will code this off stream. Miss Adventures in Astro, how are you doing on this Friday? Good to see you. So I'll do the auto updating of the title off stream. That's probably a best option. That way we can get started instead of doing even more stream makeover stuff. All right, so if Dukasoft's still around, Dukasoft tried to redeem the fake disconnect last stream and it didn't work. I have refunded those channel points, but also I have fixed it, I believe. The issue it was having is that, long story short, I changed the setup for where the file is stored when it takes a screenshot, so that was why it wasn't working properly. So we should be good now. So that's all done and dusted and fixed. The stream title I'm going to work at, I'm going to look at off stream. You're not still around your Dukasoft. Okay, all right, we're doing bad ducky stuff here, are we? I see how it is. All right, well, on that note.
The real issue was StreamerBot. Down with StreamerBot.
Okay, I'm going to guess that was Berlin. Yep, there we go. Thank you, Berlin. Yes, the TikTok TTS redemptions should be working now, including Stitch, which we had issues with last time. I'm going to go ahead and do a shout out for Bardaki, Fancy Pants shout out. There we go. I think we also have Bardaki as a command. Yes, we do. Okay, so I was actually on Bardaki's stream earlier today. He is working on an RTS game called The Unwanted War, as it says there in chat. Obviously, you've already...
Issues caused by StreamerBot. Insert smug coaster mask emote.
Now, I know you don't even need to insert smug coaster mask emote, Berlin, because not only do you have the emote, you have the coaster, which you have worn as a mask on stream. See, Magister X has got the flicky eyebrows emote too. Okay, so Bardaki, for those two people that don't know him, is a Unity game dev, and he has recently got his game onto Steam. So if you haven't already, please go ahead and wishlist it. Friend of the channel. It's a mask, not a coaster, allegedly. Okay then. So you'll be, I guess... It's a lovely story, thank you, Kotaku. So you'll be drilling holes in the side of it and attaching some elastic then, Berlin, so you can put it over your head and just wear it like a mask? Maybe? Possibly? Potentially? Okay. So, what are we doing today? We are going to be working on a new, currently untitled game. And the temporary title is called just Brains. B-R-A-I-N-S. Just because, you know... That's what zombies love to eat, apparently. So what we'll be doing is we will be heading over to the browser and YouTube itself, and we'll be looking at Project Zomboid, State of Decay 2, and World War Z, which are three games which should be good, not just for zombie games, but also third-person zombie games, which we'll be creating. So we're going to have a quick look at those three videos. We're not going to watch all of them because some of them are huge videos because they are complete playthroughs of the games. So we'll be using them for a little inspiration, if you will. And then also we'll be looking at third-person controllers, see what we can add into Unity, see which is the best one for running around with. And this is a checklist that we might not necessarily get all the way through today, depending on how time goes. But we also need to test those controllers when we find a good one to use and get the player running around in the game. And then also we need Cine Machine in there so we can get the right camera angles. All right, so we should probably pause the music at this point. And then let's have a look at this first one. I don't know if any of chat has played either of these three games, Project Zomboid, State of Decay 2, or World War Z, but we're going to have a quick look and look for some inspiration, like camera angles, things you can do in the game, all that good stuff. So we're not going to copy these games. We're going to curate the best options, best functionality from the games, and then add extra stuff to ours. So let's have a look at this one. And by the way, I have not already watched these, so if there's any language, if I start cursing like a sailor or an Irish John, for example, then I apologize in advance.
Project Zomboid has one of the steepest learning curves in any game I've played. In this series, I'm going to turn you into a zombie killing machine. First off, the tutorial. First thing you should do when you launch the game is do the tutorial. It'll give you a good rundown of all the basic mechanics and teach you about the antidote for the virus. Wink. Next step, starting your world. Always start with custom sandbox and select a starting town. I would recommend Rosewood as it's a good starting place. The zombie pop isn't too high. You can always guarantee you'll be able to get guns from the police station.
Okay, so different towns you can start in. What I was thinking, rather than having something like almost a level select, is to have it like, if anybody's watched the Walking Dead series on TV, and the first episode starts off with Rick in a hospital, if I remember correctly, and then he kind of works his way out of the hospital and progresses that way. So I think that's a bit more, I don't know, it's a fine line between realism and fun sometimes. I think that it's more fun if you can just start working your way through the level like that and expand it out. So the first point we'll have is level progression, like Walking Dead show, not to drop into specific areas of the level. Okay, and one of the things I do like about Project Zomboid, and I'm not completely sold on it yet, is that I like the camera angle when you're playing, so we might opt for the same one. Having said that, I don't want people to play it and go, oh, is he just like Project Zomboid?
Good melee weapons from the fire department and a backpack from the school. Now, this is where selecting custom sandbox is most important. There is a large variety of settings that highly customize the world you play in. From how many zombies there are, to when your water and electricity turns off, you can change everything. The only setting...
See, and for me, this is probably more of a zombie sim than anything else. It's a simulation about how the virus spreads, and it's more realistic in that it even talks about things like utility supplies being cut off. So we're probably not going to go to the sim level in the game. So we're going to say shooter rather than sim. Okay.
You should always change is in the time tab and select 5 a.m. This will be important when you start each game. Go through everything and play around with the settings. For people with lower NPCs, I would recommend not having insanely high zombie populations. and turning down the corpse removal time and blood level, as it can have some effects on your performance. Part 3. Building your character. In this part, I will cover a really basic character build that will help you get started, as well as a more advanced build to make your character stronger. The occupation I recommend while you're learning is burglar. You start with some stealth, medium fitness, and more.
Again, this is boarding on the sim level, which has, since this is going to be more of a shooter, it's not going to be too relevant, so we can probably skip certain parts of this. So, water drinks, build your character up.
Oh. Wix is your platform. Thanks, YouTube. To perform on.
Going to want to read without being somewhere safe, so you can always speed up the game time in the top right of the screen.
Game time. Oh, recommend. See a typo. Okay. Make Resident Evil game. Well, yeah, I mean, we can look at Resident Evil 2, but I think it was you that said to me, Belin, that a lot of the more recent games don't even have zombies in and certainly are not centered around zombies. So we can probably focus on the first one. I don't know what point in the series they started trailing off from having zombies as a central theme, but we can definitely look at the first one. If I put Resident Evil, it's going to find all of them. So maybe Resident Evil 1. Walkthrough. Resident Evil Remastered. Don't really want the remastered ones, do we? Well, I guess we could. Didn't have to be the original. 8 years ago. Okay, lined up. Thank you, Billy. Your wife loves Resident Evil. Ah, enough to have played all of them, or is it just the original that she loves?
I would also recommend taking weak stomach, as you aren't going to be eating rotten food anyway. Next up, prone to illness. You can counteract it with a cheaper trait, and the faster rate of zombie. It's very easy to gain weight. Eating a diet of all the snacks you can find in a gas station will rapidly increase your weight. Just try.
Okay, so we can have a certain I don't know. See, do we want to have things like, okay, you can find food and then it tops up your food level, or are we just going solely on a shooter? Because I think in the all of them, okay. How about even the VR versions? Because my understanding is they're a little bit more scary. I don't think Belint would be up for the VR versions. Dindle, how are you doing? Thanks for stopping by on this lovely Friday. Okay, so do we want to walk around and pick up food and have like a health thing? Yeah, I'm doing okay. Thank you. Yeah, I don't know how much longer this is going to last. It was kind of a December thing, so I'm not sure. We'll see. She doesn't tolerate VR well. Oh, is that like because of the motion sickness thing or just because the games are a bit more scary? Okay, so question is, if we're running around having a game similar in style to Resident Evil, do we need to have a health bar or a hunger bar and food? It is easy to get rid of. You're not wrong there, Dukasoft. Maybe I need to do a poll like Jern and say, is my beard shaved? Did
wanted
so, instead of haircutted.
$100,000 reward for his capture.
Excuse me, Papa. Why is everybody trying to claim my bounty today? Just did a double take. Yeah, must have claimed me likes it, so I'm a bit torn. What a wonderful phrase. No worries. Okay. No cares and parades. Bum, 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 bum. It means no worries for the rest of your days. It's our problem-free philosophy. Hakuna Matata. Okay, Hakuna Matata. So, yeah, I'm torn. It's kitschy and it's not great. But, you know, happy wife, happy life. So, we'll see. We'll see how it goes. Okay, so we'll find out shortly if Dukasoft is going to be $100,000 better off, or, as I suspect, I will probably escape and Dukasoft will be left penniless. I'm playing the world's smallest violin here. Okay. So where were we? We were deciding whether to have food in the game and the hunger meter, where we could potentially die. Alternatively, if we don't have hunger,
congratulations.
No.
Bit Lee the kid was caught.
No.
$100,000 for you.
No. That's the second time this stream is supposed to give me a...
Not 90% chance of escape. All right, I guess you're not penniless and on the streets, Endocasoft. Congratulations. Although I don't remember seeing the money. Did the money fly up? I don't remember seeing money. Okay. Alrighty. So, yeah, so if we don't have hunger as a way for the player to die, then the only other way would be, I guess, energy that depletes when you get attacked by the zombies and then presumably automatically tops up when they're not chewing on your neck. That tiny violin. I don't know what you're talking about. There's no bear on Jern's stream and there's no violin here, so... you must be getting mixed up with somebody's musical stream, Dukasoft. I don't know what you mean. Okay, maybe instead of food tied to health, maybe food does some sort of temp buff. How do you mean temp buff? Oh, I do like this coffee. This is Dunkin' Donuts Nutty Caramel, and it is quite delicious. Okay. So, let's... temporary buff, probably. Makes you move faster. Oh, okay. Yeah, kind of like a power-up. Okay. Yeah, we could do that. I guess the question... really, that determines it is, do we want the player to run around and kill as many zombies as possible, or also have to worry about looking in buildings and finding food to stay alive? And then if we do have hunger as an element in the game, and we have a hunger bar, obviously, do we then have a separate energy bar or health bar? Because when the zombies come up and they're attacking you, your hunger bar is not going to go down, is it? It'll go up. I guess we'd need two separate bars then, wouldn't we? Okay, so for now we're going to say food can be collected, adds to I always wonder about these, because if you have a hunger bar, that means you're hungry when it's full. Does it mean you're not hungry anymore? I don't know. I always find it funny trying to come up with the actual verbiage. Maybe it doesn't even need verbiage. Maybe I just need an icon of some food at the bottom of the bar so that we can tell what it's for. Food can be collected. Adds to hunger bar. Possible power up potential. Okay. Alrighty. As we were.
Try not to go over to 80 kg. You can find your weight in the info tab.
Again, this is sim stuff. We won't
now,
be.
Now, you could also select very getting underweight. Into this. But your fitness will take a -2 and you'll get tired. Selecting your positive traits, I always start from the bottom. Selecting my most expensive traits first, as the smaller ones don't affect your character nearly as much. Your first pick should be one of the strength and fitness traits, whether it be expensive.
Wait. Must have turbo or be a subscriber. Or both. You've got turbo and you subscribe to Ubisoft. Meeting a sandwich just chomped myself in the cheek. Oof. Yeah. That's not fun.
Passive, strong and athletic, or the cheaper, stout and fit. Strength gives you more damage with melee, opening locked windows, pushing zombies over, and you can carry more.
And then I saved hundreds with
Thanks, YouTube.
Mutual.
It's been 3 seconds. Let's have another ad.
And then I saved hundreds with Liberty Mutual. Again. And then I saved hundreds. Only pay for what you need.
Liberty, liberty, liberty.
Liberty. Liberty.
Fitness being your endurance, melee attack speed, and how fast you recover stamina. There are a lot of smaller passive effects with each trait. Spawn in will be safe. Start by shutting all the curtains to keep zombies from seeing you. You can also turn the TV on, lower the volume, and turn it to life and living.
See, again, this is all sim stuff. We're not going to have any of this.
This is why it's important to start your world at 5 a.m. Life and Living has shows that give you free XP for watching them.
Turbo Scriber, look at you. YouTube Turbo. Is that even a thing? Does anybody pay for YouTube Premium? Last time I checked, it was like $60 a month. Crazy, nobody's paying that.
First show starts at 6 a.m. And here's a timetable of the other shows for free XP. Search around your safe house. Find what food, weapons, and books or magazines you may have. A container for water is also important. You could use beer bottles, mugs, pots, or even a bleach bottle. Just make sure you tip the bleach out first. Always arm yourself with something.
They went all in on this,
whether
didn't they?
Whether it be a frying
sim
pan,
stuff.
Guitar, or a kitchen knife. You can't punch zombies in this game. So.
Okay, so now we're on to the part where it talks about weapons. You can't punch zombies. I think you should be able to punch zombies. I think if the zombie is close enough for your reach, you should be able to reach out and punch him. It's not going to do as much damage as a weapon, and it might just temporarily knock him back. But I think that needs to be a thing. Bleach, yes. Definitely public service announcement. Drinking bleach is not advisable at any time. Zombie Punch should be the game title. You know, I'm actually up for suggestions for possible game title, so I'm going to put that one in there. Zombie Punch, and not the kind of punch that you drink. Okay, so weapons. So in the weapons list, we're going to say... should we say fist or should we say hands? It doesn't really matter, but... Or we could just say punch. Weapons, punch, no damage to zombies, but knocks them back. So yeah, if you're coming up on a single zombie in the game and he's blocking the door or something, you don't have a weapon, then there's going to be proximity sensors. So when you get close to him, he's going to come over to you anyway. But if he's getting a bit too close or you just want to knock him out of the way of the door, you go out and punch him, it'll knock him back, but he won't lose any damage. Okay, so no damage to zombies, but knocks them back. I've always, ever since my first Unity project, liked the idea, and I hope this won't get me on some sort of list, of setting fire to NPCs and then having them bump into other NPCs, and then it just spreads the fire. So I think we're going to need that in the game somewhere. I don't think there's going to be flamethrowers just laying around. So maybe matches and hairspray? I'm going to put flamethrower, but also it needs to be hairspray plus matches or lighter. Does anybody use matches these days? Okay, so hairspray plus matches, lighter is a foam thrower, apparently, if you spell it wrong. Flamethrower. Okay. Puts baby on a list. Nobody puts baby in the corner, Tyndall. I'm going to say that right here and now. Okay, so we're going to have a punch. We're going to have a flamethrower. What else could we have that we could potentially find that we could use on a zombie? So we're going to be going through woods. We're going to be going through a town. Mostly deserted areas. I guess car or vehicle. Get in a vehicle and run them over. Run them over. Okay. So we can set fire to them. We can punch them. I'm not sure how I feel about decapitation yet, whether that we're going to have that in the game or not. It's something that I could do. I guess it just depends what level of gore we're going to take it to. So if we did have decapitation, what would we decapitate with? Can you reason with them? Use your charisma. I mean, given that they're called the undead, I don't think I've really seen in a show or a game where you can actually go up and reason with them. I'm actually watching season 2 at the moment of Sweet Home, which has monsters and people can go through, I think they call it monsterization. So probably while they're going through that process before they're fully monster, might be able to do something. But can you tame one? Teach it you are a food source, not a source of food. Again, we might be edging into sim territory here rather than just kind of shooting and blasting. What I'm thinking is something that where chaos reigns and you kind of, you know, you see a horde. Assassin's Creed games. Okay. I'm thinking more of kind of a blaster situation where you find a weapon, you grab it, and then you head towards the horde and take out your anger on them. I think if it was more of a simulation game, like, say, I don't know, Alpine Lake, which is an amazing game that's coming out soon, then there would be more sim involved. So on that note, I do believe that Booyah Grandma is familiar with a game called Alpine Lake, which he develops on screen, on stream even. So definitely, if you're not already following, get yourself over there. Drop him a follow, because he is an amazing game dev. He has a game which looks amazing, and it is currently wishlistable on Steam. So if you want to post the link in here, Booyah Grandma, and we can get people over there so we can get you more wish lists. But yeah, I think that level is kind of a bit too far across the sim bridge. I want to keep it more this side of the action, arcade action shooter type stuff. So there it is, Alpine Lake. In fact, let me open it up in the browser. I'm going to have a quick look. Now, I'm not logged in on this particular browser, so you won't see it wishlisted here. But when I'm logged in, I do have this game wishlisted. All right, so Mossy Grove Games. Company's not called Boo Your Grandma, contrary to popular belief. But here is the trailer, so let's have a look. See, this has good camera angles as well. So this is what I believe I have seen Booyah on stream call, and in sim, which I wouldn't want to try and say 10 times fast. But look how gorgeous this looks. It's even got fishing, look. I mean, every good game needs fishing. Can we put fishing in a zombie game? Actually, that might be something we could use as a weapon. Look, it looks great, sounds great. Wishlist now. Wise words. Alright, so that's the trailer. We have some stills as well, taken from the trailer. Yeah, get over there, get it wishlisted, because, look, planned release date this year. We're going to keep him to that. Yes. Even though he's going to be planning a big house move, he's still going to keep to 2024, I'm sure. Alrighty. Oh no, it says right there, the same as Rise of Piracy said 2022. So we're definitely going to keep you to that. Okay, alright. Back to zombie stuffs. Okay, so we can punch zombies. We have a flamethrower, which we need to find hairspray and matches or a lighter. We can use a vehicle and run them over. What else can we do with zombies? Well, we'll leave it at that for now, and then we'll see if we get any more inspiration from watching these videos.
So you need a weapon. If you find any of the beginner skill books, make sure you read them or keep them to read later. They will give you a XP multiplier to level up faster. Combining that with the TV shows, you can level up really fast. You can survive in your starter house for a sprinting. Sprinting also makes a lot of noise and you'll just tire yourself out.
Wait, did they, all those zombies just appear from nowhere?
...of escape. You walk faster than zombies, so why tire yourself out sprinting? Sprinting also makes a lot of noise and you'll just tire yourself...
They did? Did they just fade in from nowhere? That seems a bit odd. Alright, I just had a message come in. I just need to take care of something. I'll be back in 5 minutes or less. So you can enjoy some retro video gaming. In the meantime, I'll be right back. That's enough commando for now. Alrighty. Yeah, so I don't know why these zombies, whether the video is just cut like that or they're just meant to fade in. I don't know, it just seemed like odd, like they just appeared out of nowhere. They didn't walk onto the screen.
Faster than zombies, so why tire yourself out sprinting? Sprinting also makes a lot of noise and you'll just tire.
Oh, okay, it's because it's the field of view thing, isn't it? So as you see, when he turned around, it's what he can see. GTA 6 fan uses science to figure out what SPS on screen. Oh my goodness. Yeah, so as you watch this, he spins around, and then it's not until they're in his field of view that they show up.
I tire yourself out sprinting. Sprinting also makes a lot of noise, and you'll there just you tire yourself out while gathering a lot of unwanted dead attention. In your,
I don't like how it does that. If I'm facing the opposite way from them, doesn't mean I don't want to see them coming.
Display settings. Enable aim outline for any.
This game, you're not ready.
Any weapon. It will help you learn the range of your melee weapons and see which zombie you are targeting.
So there's a setting to toggle it, so it puts an outline around. No, I think we need that. I don't think we need that. If you walk up to a zombie and it's close enough that you're going to swing and use a weapon, then I think we need to say to the player, hey, look, this is the one that you're going to be hitting.
Level up your carpentry.
Okay, what we can do is we can say weapons different multiple hits, for want of a better word, to kill off zombies. So we already said the punch won't inflict any damage, it just knocks them back. The hairspray, I mean, that's fairly final, isn't it? When you set fire to one, they can wander around for a while before they collapse. But if they wander around and then bump into other zombies, they can ignite them as well. Vehicle, we're just going to run them over. I don't think it's much recovering from that. So vehicle, we can say, is one hit. Flamethrower is also going to be one hit, because once you set fire to them, that's it. And the punch has no damage. So really, it's only going to be when we have weapons we can carry beyond the flamethrower that we're going to need to inflict multiple strikes.
Early on, you can disassemble furniture, including beds, chairs, and tables. Make sure to read the books for that XP multiplier. Leave your car running. Leaving my car running has saved me multiple times where I've gotten overwhelmed and had to retreat back to the car.
It's a TD in the house. Terrier Darts. Good to see you. Welcome in. Happy Friday. Hope it's going well for you. So, even though I haven't changed the title on this stream, I'm going to auto-change it with StreamerBot after we finish today. We're working on a side project. This is Derail Day, as I put in the schedule on Discord. And we're going to be working on a zombie game. So, Monday and Wednesdays will be Homeward Hound working with the dogs. And Friday is something a little different, and we're doing a side project. So, we're just looking through some videos to get some inspiration. See which direction we're going to take it. So we have Project Zomboid, then State of Decay 2, World War Z, and Resident Evil Remastered. I also don't like that when he goes up to the car, he just disappears inside it. think I prefer it where it's animated and you have to open the car door and you have to get in and then shut the car door. And I think adding that extra time means there's going to be more tension when there's a zombie coming towards you if you want to get in your car. Now, what happens when you're in the car? What can they do? Can they do anything to you? Other than swarm?
You never want to get eaten through the car window while you're trying to start it.
Eaten through the car window? What? Oh, so they can actually smash the glass. Interesting. Do we want to have that? Would they be able to smash the glass? And again, you know, the level of detail, they've smashed the glass and all we see is dark grey, like the glass is still there, so definitely some improvements to be made. The downside is if we are going to have smashable glass, we need to have a vehicle that has separate glass meshes for each window. I do have glass that I can put in that is a breakable glass asset, so we could have it so they could smash it, but I do like the idea of being able to smash the glass, but how do you determine whether a zombie can break the glass or not? In this instance, it just looks like the amount of time that they were stood at the window, because this character here, we look where we are, 808 in the video, we come back. I think she was at the vehicle the longest, and that's what gave her the ability to break the window. Yeah, so she's here. She's pushing out the way.
You never want to get eaten through the car window while you're trying to start it.
So the only way I see that that would be possible is to have something like that where you have a collider and whichever zombie is standing there the longest then has the ability to break the glass. Got Wayne's on my mind. One lion, how the devil are you? Thanks for stopping in. You've got Wayne's on your mind. They want Wayne's on their dinner plate, so it's slightly different. Demonic, is that the right response? I guess it depends on the question. Okay, so I think we're going to put it in as a possibility. I like the idea that when you're in the car, you're not 100% safe. Otherwise, you just get in your car and without anything like a timer counting down that they can break the glass, you would just sit there in the car, they would swarm around it, and then you would reverse away. So there's no tension there. So I think we're going to go with breakable glass, which might be an interesting challenge to implement it. Breakable glass in car, depending on how long has been at the window. I turned around, do my pillow back and relax. I told you that it will be in the. Okay. That makes sense. Yes. You got Wayne's on your mind because I said, "How in the devil are you?" It's my own fault. I apologize. I don't know what to tell you. Okay. So we will have possibly breakable glass. I do have glass, like I said, that can break, so it's something that we could put in. Ideally, the player would have a vehicle with the glass, like we said, as separate meshes, so that each one we could break out separately, or maybe only the driver's window is breakable, because there wouldn't be much point unless they're going to climb in the vehicle of them breaking any of the other glass with the. They broke the back window or the back door windows. So then do we say that you can only get in the car on the driver's side? Cleaning up the aftermath of the disaster that was the hardware upgrade fiasco. It felt like typing a thing to you. You can always type things to me, one line. I like it when people type things. We don't even mind the lurkers that don't want to type and just want to be present, so it's all good. Okay, so breakable glass in car, depending on how long zombie has been at the window. Let's say only driver's window can be broken. Vehicles can only be entered and exited. Not existed. Vehicles can only be entered and exited by driver's door. Okay, so the assumption being that if you go around to the other doors, they're locked, and we could even put a message on screen to say that. That will help with things like animations and just make it a little easier to understand the rules.
Negative moodles affect your damage with any weapon.
Moodles?
Try to take care of as many as you can before fighting zombies. You can use beta blockers to remove panic.
Axe, that's something you might find lying around, especially in the woods if someone has been chopping firewood. So to our weapons list, we have punch, flamethrower, vehicle. We now have axe. Now how many hits are we going to say that an axe has to, how many times does an axe have to hit the zombie before they're finished off? I mean, in this one, it looked like two or three, didn't it?
Try to take care of as many as you can before fighting.
Wow, that's actually, given that's an axe, that's a pretty resilient zombie taking that many blows.
Negative moodles affect your damage with any weapon.
3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. I think I counted 11 hits there. I don't think we want to have 11 hits. That's a bit extreme. If it's an axe, even for a zombie. Let's say three. Three hits. Now, could the axe be used after three hits? We talked about decapitation. One, two, three. If the hits are going to be to the head, potentially it could be a decapitation weapon. All right, I'll put it in as a possible. Possible decap weapon. Okay.
Use beta blockers to remove panic, painkillers for pain, and cigarettes for stress. Guns are very loud, and ammo isn't infinite. Only use them if you have to. When using guns, if your aim skill is very low, stick to shotguns. You won't.
Okay. Shotguns seem to be the weapon of choice for zombie films and zombie games, so potentially we could find a shotgun if we were going looking through houses and things. How many hits are we going to say for a shotgun? I think that's just a pretty much a single hit, isn't it? Now, shotguns do a spread shot, don't they? So you could possibly take out more than one zombie if they were next to each other. So we're going to say possible multi-zombie kill. Combo points. Turning into a pinball game now. Alright.
Won't be able to hit any zombies with a rifle at level 0. There is a Project Zomboid map that shows you the entire vanilla map. I always have it open on the second monitor, and I'll include it in the description. Hitting zombies with your car will damage the part you hit it with. Once your hood is broken, your engine will start taking damage, leading to your car stall.
Yeah, again, this is bordering on the sim level, isn't it? We're not going to have car damage. What we could do, though, I think we probably need a fuel level once you're in the car. We have breakable glass in car, depending on how long zombie's been at the window. Only driver's window can be broken. Vehicles can only be entered and exited by a driver's door. And fuel gauge on screen. Oh, how's if you can spell gauge? On screen for each vehicle. Limited fuel. Okay, so you're not going to have damage to the vehicle, but you can only drive your vehicle around for so long before it runs out of fuel. Abadu, how you doing? Good to see you. Hope your Friday is treating you well. So, limited fuel. When fuel runs out, player auto exits vehicle and cannot re-enter. So you can only get into vehicles having a fuel to drive in. Or should we? Should that stop you? No. When fuel runs out, player auto exits vehicle. Vehicles with zero fuel can be entered, but not driven. I don't know why you'd want to get in a vehicle given that having it so the zombies can smash the glass, but... Okay.
Surely you can't be serious.
I am serious, and don't call me Shirley.
Thank you. Okay. See, now also, this is something that we can implement. If there's a horde, you can't just drive through them like there's one and just carry on going the same speed. It needs to slow the vehicle down. So, vehicle speed reduced by number of zombies in front of it. Okay. Reverse into zombies too. What we'll also have is what's the best way of wording this? Let's say blood stains where kills occur.
In the next episode, I'm going to cover your first weeks in game and a detailed combat tutorial. Until then, keep slaying.
Oh, I might come back to this series because it seems quite inspiring. Since we get these lovely YouTube ads out the way.
So, you've survived.
Okay, so let's take a look at State of Decay 2. So this has a different art style. It also has a different character controller. Different camera angles. Quite different from Project Zomboid. It's more realistic. Bigger zombies.
Now it begins, guys.
Damn, what is that stuff? It's like its whole body is an open wound.
Okay, so this has gates that can be closed to keep zombies back. So we need something like that. Gates and doors. Can be closed. Keep zombies at bay.
We should keep moving. No telling how long that gate's gonna last.
We probably don't need all this dialogue. It's gonna be more of a shooter.
So they're talking about this special zombie here, the red one, that is a plague zombie, which we're gonna learn a little bit about here as we go forward. But
tell me again why this was a good idea.
So you can see actual weapons they're carrying. I don't think we're going to have that. Now if we have we should have it where it's just a single weapon. So if you pick up a shotgun and you're walking around with a shotgun and then you find an axe, then we'll have it where it puts the shotgun down and you pick up the axe rather than unrealistically saying, well, we're going to carry a shotgun and an axe and a flamethrower and this and that and the other, and then have to keep some kind of UI or count on screen of which weapons we have. So under weapons, can only carry one at a time. Picking up another. What's the current weapon? Okay.
The army's in here. They've gotta have food to share.
Okay, so you're just starting off. The survivors they give you don't really have much on them. Now, I'm going to give you guys a little tip right now. Before you walk out into this area, you see this baseball bat on your back? The game actually has a system set up where it's gonna do something to this baseball bat. Now, what I advise you to do, this is a little cheese, remove the baseball bat before you even walk through these doors. Don't drop it. Just pull it out of your, like, open your inventory. On PC, it's tab. I don't know what it is on controller, but whatever your inventory button is. And then unequip the bat, okay? So now when you walk out here, you're good. In State of Decay, no matter what, if you don't have a weapon equipped, you still will always have your little sidearm here. Some people have kitchen knives, screwdrivers, and whatnot. You'll always have this to fight with no matter what.
That's interesting. So we'd said originally, okay, we can have punches. But in State of Decay 2, you always have a sidearm. Do we always want to have a weapon? Is that going to make it a bit too easy? Yeah, I don't think we're going to have a weapon.
So let's get out here. There's going to be a couple zombies that you're going to have to fight.
Shouldn't be zombies inside the fences, right?
Better question, where are all the people?
They can't all be gone.
They sure left a lot of stuff behind.
Now, when you see the little highlight in the square right there, those containers can be looted. That means there's stuff in them. If you don't see a highlight, you don't have to like go around and like check all these crates or nothing like that.
Thanks
there's not
for the
be
follow.
Anything in them.
Okay, so what we could do is when we enter a new scene or when we go somewhere we haven't been before, is we can have an outline around things you can pick up. Otherwise, you're just going to be stumbling around scenes and not really being sure what you can pick up. So weapons, going to carry one at a time, pick it up and drop the current weapon. Outline to show where weapons are. Okay, thank you for that follow. New follower we just received.
Only containers that have loot in them will flash like this. Now, when you're going through this tutorial area, I do advise you to just grab everything. You know why not?
Perfecto mundo.
It'll help out. So these bandages here you use to heal, like you see how I have a little bit of damage there, so you can go and use this.
That's the last one.
It'll heal it right up. Now I'm going to still keep that bat unequipped. Like I said, we don't want it to break. But when you're 1v1 with a zombie, the screwdriver's good enough.
Best find of the day.
Got another bandage. So like I said, the bandages are heal items. More bandages. Finding healing items for days. But as you can see, throughout this whole area, there's little bits of loot scattered all over the place. Now, as you guys see here, when you go to search, you get that search wheel that pops up. And you guys see how it says fast search. Now, fast searching is something that you can do, but you risk a search crash. And what I mean by a search crash is it'll just like, boom, it'll make a bunch of noise and it'll attract zombies. A lot of people do fast search in the early
Okay, so this is the second game that we've looked at, and it's the second time they've talked about noises attracting zombies, so we probably need to address that. So what we can say is noises attract zombies, but what would constitute a loud noise? So we're going to say the shotgun being fired. Breaking down doors. Smashing windows. And driving. Noise of the engine. Okay. Do for starters.
Difficulties, it's not the end of the world, but what happens is you build bad habits. If you get used to fast searching, you're going to keep fast searching. And when you're in the higher difficulties and you fast search, it could literally get you killed. So I always advise people, don't fast search. There's skills you can learn later on in the game that allow you to fast search and not get that search crash. But early on in the game, hey, just take your time. You can like feather a little bit of fast search in if you want, but you're risking a search crash, and to me it's not worth it. Like, yeah, you might save a couple seconds on that search, but now you're gonna lose minutes because now you got to spend all this time fighting off these zombies, using resources, bullets, ammo, health, stamina to fight off the zombies you just attracted to save a couple seconds. So realistically, you're losing time fast searching, so it's something to keep in mind. I don't fast search all that much unless I have a person that can do it without getting the search crash.
Okay, so seeing that tree there, should we have climbable objects? Yes. Maybe. It's going to be more of a shooter, and you want it to be action. Do we really want to be hiding up trees, waiting for zombies to pass? Could we somehow use the trees as weapons? All right, I'll come back to that.
Okay, so as soon as you find, like right there, that was a search crash. And now you see how I just attracted these zombies. I could have fought these zombies 1v1. But like I said, it's not too bad right now in the tutorial area, but that could...
All right, Molotov cocktails. I think we need to get those in there somewhere as weapons. And how do we create a Molotov cocktail? So the flamethrower was hairspray plus matches or a lighter, and a Molotov cocktail is alcohol bottle plus, I mean, obviously you're going to need matches or lighter at some point because you've got to set fire to it. But we also need a rag of some sort, don't we? We can put inside it. So it's probably going to be unavoidable having a UI on screen with certain things you're carrying, even if we don't do it with weapons. Because if you need to find, in the case of Molotov cocktails, three items, a bottle, a rag, and matches or a lighter, then unless they're just happen to be all together in a nice little pile ready for you, or unless we have the alcohol bottle with the rag in already just laying on the ground, would still be two components, wouldn't it? Okay. So we will need UI to show what you are carrying, but it won't be actual weapons themselves. It'll be components of things like bottles, rags, matches, etc.
Really gets you in trouble later on. Okay, so these right here, these bag of snacks, these are stamina items. So as you notice, as you fight, that blue bar over near the minimap goes down. And this is your stamina, like your oxygen. So the more you use it, the more you use it, eventually when you fully run out, which I'm going to try to run my stamina all the way down right now for you, your character slows down big time. Wicked ineffective.
Okay, I like the idea of that. So if we have UI for stamina, using weapons, reduces bar, but resting increases, bar is reduced, so is air speed. Okay.
Can't dodge or anything like that. So watch your stamina, but what happens is if your stamina is all the way down like this and you use one of those snacks, it'll instantly fill your stamina back up. Or you can just wait a few seconds and I'll show you guys here. Just wait a few seconds and your stamina will passively start regenning. Now another little trick you can do to get your stamina to go up faster is crouch. And when you crouch, your stamina goes up really, really fast.
Too many Z's behind us to go back now. Might as well keep looking around.
All right, so I believe this toolbox is where you'll find a new weapon.
Now this is
there. It is.
That'll come in handy.
Okay, so now that we did.
All right, so we said outline to show where weapons are. So we can redefine that and say outline around weapon or furniture to show where weapons are. So if it's in a cupboard or something, it's in a drawer, then I'll have an outline around the furniture, and then we'll be able to find the weapon.
That the reason you're like, Brian, why would you do that, dude? It's just a baseball bat. Baseball bats are actually pretty good weapons in this game. So now I'm going to re-equip the baseball bat because I like it a bit better than a crowbar. It's a little lighter.
Baseball bat. We'll have that as another weapon. We've got punch, knows I'm damaged to zombies, but knocks them back. Baseball bat. I think we're going to say 5 hits for that. We said 3 for the axe. So 5 hits for the baseball bat. Don't think we need to say any more on that. Can't really use a baseball bat as a decapitation weapon. I mean, depending on how hard you swing it, I guess, but... Okay.
It has really, really good knockdown.
That even after this long, people kept hoping we'd find their families again.
Yeah, just like mom hoping you'd come home when she got sick. Didn't happen either.
I had a job and a life, unlike some people.
Somebody had to take care of her. Sure wasn't gonna be you.
I'm not getting into this again. Not now.
Now, sometimes you'll find little things like this. These are just like notes, like little lore, things like that. They're not junk. They don't particularly do anything. Like, you know, if you just want to collect them and, like, you know, have them in your base, like, so be it. But they don't really do anything other than that. But you can sell them. They are worth a little bit of what the currency in this game is called influence. So just imagine it's money. You can sell these to traders for a little bit of influence. And so I advise you to just pick it up. Now, if you look on the board here, some of these characters are actually from State of Decay 1. Like, that's Marcus. I believe that's Jacob Ritter, Lily's brother, Maya. Those are characters from the first game.
Perfecto mundo.
Awesome. Yeah, like I said, grab everything you can in this area. It's free loot. Okay, so the but stealth plays a big part in this game. See, a lot of bandages.
Yo, that's a lot of zombies.
We can get past them if we're quiet.
So here they're just teaching you about stealth, crouch down. In this game, if you can't avoid a fight, avoid it. You know what I mean? Because every fight costs resources.
Okay, so when we look at our third person controllers, you need ability to crouch.
So come up on the zombie. They're trying to show you. You can also use stealth kills. You sneak up behind a zombie, you'll see the pop up. You hit it, and you'll stealth kill a zombie from behind. Now, you can only do stealth kills from behind while you're crouched. But stealth plays a big part in this game, especially if you want to save resources and stuff like that.
I've been researching blood plague with some other civilians.
Okay, so I like the idea of going into dark places to build the tension. So, flashlight for dark areas.
We found a cure that works if you use it soon after infection. The army took our lab when they left, but they didn't get everything. Did you find it? No cure? Damn. I'll need an infirmary to culture a new dose.
Guys, new players to play on this map anyways. It's a very, very good map for new players.
Hello, Mrs. Big Gamey. Good to see you. Hopefully you're not working too hard. I know zombies are not your favorite, and that's what we're looking at today, so just a heads up.
The loot distribution's really nice. The bases are pretty good.
Good to know. How are you feeling, little brother?
Like I got hit by a truck. This place doesn't have enough.
I think I saw a place where we can find all the samples.
Dodge button in State of Decay. If you can dodge multiple different ways. Screen right here. You. The same. The tutorial will be the tutorial missions will always be the same. But once you're in a regular game, the missions you don't start with any toolkits. You don't. I gotta find a new one. Go and claim a outpost.
I'm headed out for a little bit.
Shot and get out of there.
See you soon. Do I do any reverse engineering? No, I do not. Jingles, do you do any reverse engineering? I'm assuming you're talking about things like downloading APKs from the Google Play Store and then unpacking them to see what happens in the game. I'm aware of the process if that's what you're talking about, but I haven't actually done any of it myself. But thanks for stopping by.
Oh, nice, more bullets. Okay, so let's get these resources back home. We have more missions, obviously, that are popping up, but I'm going to loot, get the stuff back home. and then go out. Make sure you always empty your inventory. I've watched a lot of people play this game, and they'll loot, and then they'll go back to base, or they won't go back to base, and they'll just walk around with just...
So if you're interested in joining a community project called H1MEU, the reverse engineering, just survive. Oh, okay. Yeah, I don't really have any bandwidth at the moment for taking on new projects, but I appreciate the suggestion. Thank you.
Tons of stuff on them. Only carry what you need on you. If you have excess stuff, just swing by your base or an outpost, which we'll get into here in a little bit, and drop it off. This car isn't fully repaired. A lot of the times, you know, imagine it as like a vehicle that has a health bar. That health, you know, that just fixed it 70% of out of 100. But it's good enough. I always say, don't waste your toolkits until your vehicle's smoking, because if not, then you're not getting the most out of it.
So we're not going to go to that level, like we said before, of having damage to vehicles, a vehicle smoking. We'll just have whether you're having enough fuel to continue driving it around or not. All right, I need to get a refill on my drink, so I will be right back. Commando came up again. This actually, it picks a random video from one of 14, so I'm surprised we've had Commando twice today. All right.
As long as your vehicle's not smoking, it's good to go. But we got about a little less than half a tank of gas, which is fine, because I don't want to use any of my base supplies. Right now, if I wanted gas, if I come here, we have none. My base has zero gas in it.
Okay, so are we going to have it where there's just a vehicle that has a certain amount of fuel in, and once you've used it, that's it? That was my original thought. Because even if you can find a gas station, are you going to be able to buy gas to put in it? Possibly. Let's put it on here. Fuel gauge on screen for each vehicle. Limited fuel. Can find limited number of gas stations. Fortnite player recreates that Saltburn scene in game. Okay.
But you can use your fuel supply at base to craft gas cans with this function here. So you see load gas can. You can do it from here, or you can come to your storage and you can do it from here. It costs one base fuel and it'll give you one gas can. For right now, I don't want to do that. We'll go out and loot for fuel. As you guys know, we just cleared out a gas station that had zombies at it. We can get fuel from there. So I would say just this is more than enough fuel to make it to the outpost. I'm going to loot some fuel before I craft it. So get our lights on. Let's head down to this outpost. A horde of zombies. Now, don't run into zombies with the front of your car. This game, cars do break quite easily.
Okay, so something I haven't considered yet is a day-night cycle. I don't want it to have, since it's supposed to be a shooter, supposed to be action, I don't want to have like a whole bunch of keys and you need 20 fingers to be able to play it. So on the day-night cycle, car alerts automatically turn on when in cars. Okay.
If you're running into zombies, but you can open your door and hit them with the door. I'll show you here. So these are armored zombies right here.
Happy about this aggressive plan of ours.
I get what you're saying, but I don't see that we have a choice.
Looks like this place got overrun. I see uglies in army camo all
over. They're probably wearing bulletproof helmets. Handheld weapons are a better choice here.
Yeah, I got it.
Zombies wearing bulletproof helmets. Okay.
I gotta rest.
You gotta watch those executions, because as you can see, when you get locked into those animations, the zombies can hit you. So I advise you not to do executions, especially with these weapons, blunt weapons, because they can be time consuming. But these are armored zombies. Anytime you get around like a military location, these guys, their helmets are bulletproof. So shooting them doesn't do much. Now, you can shoot them enough times and eventually knock their helmets off, or if you have a really, really high caliber gun, like a 50 cal, you could shoot right through the helmet. But these guys have to abandon building, and it's just like, you know, like Daisy, you could find like random stuff. And once you got this safe zone, anything like that. But this one doesn't have a sight either. Boom, 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 boom. You know what I mean? But like I said, guns are loud without suppressors, so use it as a last resort.
Okay, so going back to the vehicles, we said we can reverse into zombies too and break through locked gates with the vehicles.
Now, these rucksacks, you can't store these in your outpost. You actually have to bring these back to base. So I store them in the trunk. They're very, very heavy. So if you have those on your back, make sure you try to not get in any fights. And if you do get in a fight, drop it on the ground or put it in a car or something like that as soon as you can, just to So you're not tiring your survivor out. Look, we just found more bolts. But now we'll be able to keep this crossbow in the fight for a while. You can craft bolts too in your workshop. I'm going to teach you guys here about scouting the map. All over the map, you'll see these binocular icons. These are scouting sites. And there it is. Now, one thing I didn't discuss is in the fire, in their base, there's a tower. I need guns. I need ammo. I'll loot this one too. Now, when we get back to base, each survivor has their own individual inventory. So,
okay, so looking at the camera positions on this one, it looks like it's a zoomed in camera position to get you in on the action until you get in a vehicle and then it zooms out. So we might utilize that as well. I'm going to say camera zooms out when driving.
So you got to make sure that if you want your like person who's out on mission that you're actively playing, nice, we just got a gas can, to have the crossbow, you have to take it off this survivor, or if not, they'll just keep it on them. So and use your lights for use your lights at night. It's very, very dark. This was actually a recent update, you know, back in the day in State of the Game, when you got out your car, your lights would automatically turn off. But the game's quite dark. So say you pull up to a really, really dark area that you want to loot. You can now get out of your car and your lights will stay on and they'll light up the area. So it's not like super, super dark for you.
Okay, so initially, what we're going to have, at least initially, is when it's nighttime, the lights on the vehicle will come on automatically when you get in the car, and then when you get out of the car, they will turn off.
It's one thing that you can use your lights for. Use it to light up an area at night. But if you don't want to do that and your lights are kind of bothering you, you just hit the button, turn them off.
This place is running low on fuel, man. We gotta fill her up.
So, for instance, like, now that the survivor's tired, what I personally like to do is I'll give them a weapon for base defense. Now, I'll take all the weapons off that I want to keep. I'll take the stuff off like this. And then I want them to still be able to defend the base. So what I'll do is I'll give them a different rifle. Like, I know I'm not going to use this AR-15, so I can have her inventory, the trench tool.
All right. I think we've got as much out of video as we can. So next up, we have World War Z. I've seen the movie. I haven't played the game. Let's have a look.
We're so small, really. Insignificant. In the grand scheme, one life means so little. You dedicate yourself to a principle. But in the end, it's out of your control. In this world, principles get you killed. You lend a hand, it gets torn off. You hesitate, you die. So you want to save someone? Save yourself.
Bronco, I will leave your ass here.
Nobody is leaving anybody.
We're gonna steamroll the army and then they'll be back. This is our only chance to get out.
Not going into the subway. You've heard the stories.
We will starve here. The subway is our only chance. We take it to Inwood, get to the evac center, and get out of New York. Or we die here.
I don't like him, but he's right.
Thank you.
be quiet here.
Creeper is close.
Dan, you hear me?
Hey, what's up? I don't see you guys on the roof.
Again, this is a different camera angle. This is kind of over the shoulder view. A bit of a more realistic look.
Going for it. Trying the subway to Inwood. Over.
Yeah, really? I don't... Maybe the grunts will wipe them out on the front. Guys?
Come on now, Creep.
Don't stop until you get to the elevator.
Creeper's gone.
Needs to be a shooter at this point. Oh god. More ads.
In 2020.
Americans, man, love everything! What now? Bigger guns!
Okay, we good?
But I didn't have time to store any food. I was busy making music. We're not good yet.
I swear to God.
Reloading. Creeper.
Creeper's gone.
A lot more fast moving. I've forgotten that. What was he there? The speedy zombies. Shooter. Sure, we're gonna get much out of this one. It just seems like a shooter. Another one that was recommended research is Death Road to Canada. Randomly generated road trip.
In this video, I'll go over tips I wish I knew when I started playing Death Road to Canada. I did a ton of research for you. Make sure to sub and check out the links in the description to see more details. Let's start with the basics. Always be on the lookout for sparkles. This means there's something you can loot or a door you haven't gone through yet. When they notice you, zombies will move in a straight line towards you. They'll only go around walls if they get pushed to the side by the crowd. When they reach out and grab you, it'll slow you down, but they need a bit of time before they can officially bite you. Be quick and evade or kill them before that happens. And you don't have to kill every zombie since they don't drop any loot or experience, but if you can't run, try to melee them down and conserve your ammo. Gunfire and all noises like barking and horns agitate zombies. Save ranged weapons for sieges or when you're overwhelmed. If you attack too much, your face will start flashing red and eventually you'll start sweating buckets.
Okay, so we're gonna have... and the noises attract zombies, shotgun, breaking down doors, smashing windows, driving. Habit where you can throw objects to distract them.
In this state, you'll move slower, and your attacks will do next to nothing, so stop swinging and flee, or pull out your firearm. And you can set your party stance in the team menu to run or fight when needed. Tossing furniture is way better than risking your weapon's durability, and when zombies fall, they can't attack and take more damage, so use this opportunity to flee or finish them off. Also, look through doorways to see if there are too many zombies on the other side. It's wise to fight them as they funnel through a doorway. You can even close the door, which should buy you some time as the zombies try to break through. You can have up to 4 people in your party, but more fighters also means more food consumption. Once you've looted everything, head back to your car. Note that you can access the trunk to change your loadout or to drop off weapons if you have enough time to run back and grab some more.
Yeah, we're not going to use the car for storage like that.
Otherwise, hop in, hold the action button to start the car and drive off. Giver, eh? You can only save when your car is on the road. Just pause the game and with their charm. Also note that driving around uses gas, but always improves the next options. But be careful. Losing your car opens you up to nearly constant negative events and bandit attacks until you get your next vehicle. Some car types are easier to repair than others, requiring a smaller mechanical skill. Engines lose health as you drive, but the chassis will take damage when you run into zombies or when your car is hit. If your engine dies, someone with good mechanical skill can try to repair it, but if the chassis reaches zero, your car will explode, damaging everyone in and around the car. For this reason, you might have to clear. Character has a bad sleep or is overused during random events, they can become tired. When this happens, their strength, fitness, and shooting is reduced by 3 points. This debuff will go away if you go to sleep.
Debuff, this is what was mentioned earlier in the stream.
The team rolls before a mission, which means they won't go out with you. You can also just ignore the debuff and be smart about your engagements. Unfortunately, the AI isn't smart about attacking. For example, some weapons hit more than one enemy at a time, but the AI tends to swing from max range even if it causes them so much fatigue. For this reason, light weapons are very helpful. I cover weapons in another video, but here are some good ones to look out for. Many weapons have durability, but other...
Aluminum bat, hammer, crowbar, frying pan, hatchet, spear. Where would you find spears, though? If it's not a sim game where you make them yourself, I don't think you just walk around and find spears in the level, would you?
Others are unbreakable, like these ones.
Nightstick, rebar, rubber mallet, screwdriver, tire iron, extreme. So not just a hockey stick, but an extreme hockey stick.
I'm recommending you keep. If you gather all your characters together, you can pause the game and choose the swap meet to move weapons between characters, and selecting a weapon and placing it in the same slot will lock it, forcing the character to use it exclusively. And if you want to drop a weapon, just hold down the pickup button.
And last but not least, and some would consider the OG, we have Resident Evil. This is the remastered version, so let's see how this looks.
Alpha team is flying around the forest zone, situated in northwest Raccoon City, where we are searching for the helicopter of our compatriots, Bravo team, who disappeared during the middle of their mission. Bizarre murder cases have recently occurred in Raccoon City. There are outlandish reports of families being attacked by a group of about 10 people. Victims were apparently eaten. The Bravo team was sent in to investigate, but we lost contact.
Look, Chris!
Bravo team's helicopter was a derelict. Save for the remaining body of Kevin.
Yeah, so the original game had fixed cameras, didn't it? Almost like CCTV cameras. there's no following of the player. It just switches between cameras, which, remember, when I played the original, can be a little jarring. So these are bigger houses. I was thinking more kind of projects on board where you go in, it's just easier to get through the smaller buildings. I don't think we need anything this elaborate.
What's going on around here? I can't figure it out.
Same here.
Chris and now Wesker.
Music to build the tension. Hello, Popper. There were zombies in this game, right? Walking around.
Ah. Jill.
Barry, I didn't mean to get you that excited.
Right. Anyway, you should.
Oh, there is a zombie. Okay. What about zombies that are laying down that come back to life? That's a possibility, isn't it? Laying down, apparently dead in quotes. Come back to life. Proximity detection. It's very jarring when the camera keeps flipping all over the place. Well, zombie birds. sure about having any zombie animals in the game. Okay, so there's the flamethrower we talked about earlier. Being able to push objects, do we want that? Probably not really going to need that, because it's not like the majority of it's going to be set inside buildings. I don't think there's much outside that you would need to give a push to. We need big snakes. I recognise that sound. Must be the one and only, the inimitable Man of Clay. How are you doing, Clayman? Good to see you. Thanks for stopping by. Yeah, I haven't updated the title of the stream, but it's Derail Day on Fridays, so we're doing a side project which is going to be a zombie shooter. So we've just been looking through various current zombie games to get some inspiration, start building stuff up. So yeah, it's not that I've suddenly decided Homeward Hound is going to have zombies in it. But what I am doing after the stream is I'll be updating StreamVODs to automatically update the title depending on the day. So when I go live on a Monday and a Wednesday, it'll say what it does now, and then when I go live on Fridays, my derail day, it should update it to say zombie stuffs. Anyway, hope your Friday is going well. Okay. Are you saying that zombies don't fit every game? No, I'm not saying that at all. And, you know, there could be some DLC for Homeward Hound in the future. Maybe, possibly, potentially, that, you know, you could put zombies into the game or zombie dogs. Who knows? We shall see. Never say never, that's what I say. So this is the last one we're looking at for today, Resident Evil Remastered. Just see if we can get any more inspiration. Decided as much fun as huge zombie serpents are, I probably don't need those in the game I'm creating. And we're not going to have an inventory of weapons like this. The most our player is going to be able to carry is items to make weapons, like a rag, a bottle of alcohol, and a lighter or matches for a Molotov cocktail. Again, with the pushing things, I don't think we're going to be needing to push anything in the game. It might change. Did you know the name Molotov cocktail originates from? I did not. That is interesting. Yeah, I don't know why. I just assumed for some reason it was Russia. I don't know why. Molotov sounds a bit Russian, I guess. But that's a good to know. TIL, today I learned. My new SO command is working. Okay, it should do the fancy pants shout out, which it does. So, to those not currently following Clayman, who's working on an epic game, is it Clayman or Clay the command? Oh, Clayman is for your sound, I guess. Hey, you can never hear that too often, right? Clay, there it is. Okay. So, get yourself over there and follow Clayman for some game dev stuff. There's going to be some game dev stuff on here soon. I'm not just watching videos all day, as fun as this is. But yeah, drop a wish list on his Epic Hero game that he's working on with Black Mage UK, aka Marcus. And yeah, fun time to be had over on Clayman's stream. I think you did stream today. Do I remember seeing a notification? I didn't manage to get to the stream today, but I think you were on. Unless that was yesterday. It's been a bit of a blurry week, to be honest. World War II, when the Russians came over, they said they weren't bombing us, but dropping bread caskets, so Finns came up with a name, Molotov cocktails. I did not know that. That's kind of hilarious. Not sure we're going to get much more out of this game. So this is probably the ending, given that it says walk through complete game, so I don't want to spoil it. We'll end it there. So we'll close out Project Zomboid that we looked at, close out State of Decay 2 and Resident Evil. Show Unity. Okay, let's have some music back on. Daddy has credit cards. What? All right, put days on. Okay, so this is a basic project that I created off stream that should have all the zombie characters in. that I purchased recently, Toon Zombies and Toon Zombies Extended. And then also I won this asset called Mist Village on the Messy Coda stream. Let's see if we can do a Messy Coda. he does a lot of Unity game dev streams. He has a lot of raffles where he gives away assets and he interviews asset developers. And also has a, I believe, a 24-hour charity stream coming up soon. So definitely get over there, drop him a follow so you can watch him stream that. Okay, so this is the demo scene, or one of the demo scenes from Mist Village, which I thought about using for the game, but I think it's gonna be a bit too detailed. Wait, what? Pog Champ. What part of Pog is pig? Why does it put pig on my head for Pog? It should detect pig and it should detect hog. At no point should it detect Pog. I don't know. Okay, so this is the Mist Village scene. Which is all very nice and highly detailed. I thought I might be able to use it. But I don't think so, especially since it's more kind of medieval, kind of period looking, which I'm not really going for. So I think we'll probably not use that asset. Lovecraftian Village, that's it, that's what it was called. Code does what it wants, right? Never a truer word spoken. So I guess this whole D-Link folder can go. Best not to delete a scene once you're in the scene. Yep, there we go. Okay, so BG scenes, we should have something temporary scene that we had set up previously. If Unity gives us the engine back, there we go. Okay, level one. Don't save that one. Okay, so this was one of the characters. Zoom in here. One of the characters from the zombie pack. Not sure if we put any animations on him yet. He has a controller and an avatar. Okay, so we just have an animation controller. Okay, so the only thing that we didn't have before when we looked at this, or when I looked at it, was we didn't have a player character. So we're gonna have to try and find a character with a similar kind of aesthetic to this, which is almost PS2. Style. In the character packs we have Toon Zombies and these prefabs, and then if we change this so we can see the characters and then some, so we've got TZM, Zombie 1, Zombie 2, so fairly standard stuff. And the extended pack, where I think also has females in, has the option to do severing limbs, all that good stuff that you need in zombie games. Yeah, so this is the basic Toon Zombie pack, and then we have Toon Zombies Extended, which has also female civilians. Got some lady zombies. Also have some more males in here that we didn't have in the original pack. And then also specials. So we have infected, so they're more decomposed. Hulk, so we can have kind of boss level type zombies. Definitely more decomposition on this one. And then soldiers. Soldier with a bulletproof vest. Soldier with no vest. Priest. So we could have a church, and we could have the priest in the church, of course. Police, if we have a disused police station or abandoned police station. So, yeah, stuff to be done. All right, so one of the things I wanted to look at was if we show browser, we go back here and we look at my current assets. I need to find a good third-party controller. Now, what about Croc Man? I wonder if he'll be any good for the actual player character. Because with post-processing and distancing the camera, we can mix together different art styles. Crocman, though, I'm thinking, looking at his face, he might be part croc himself. Maybe not. Could use him as a placeholder, maybe. We have another character. So what we're looking for really is controller. This is one I got recently, I think, in a bundle. Two TPS, third person shooter, asset. Okay, realistic locomotion, dynamic rotation, support root motion, step up system, advanced ragdoll. Unclick to set up a JU character. And to use JU TPS. Documentation. Foot placement. Nice. Third person. Top down. FPS 2.5D side scroller. Okay. Physical bullets, dual wielding, ricochet system, scope system, support melee weapons. Inventory system, pick up, equip, drop, and use items. Cross-platform inputs. Gravity switch, change the gravity. Yeah, I don't think we need to change gravity. Motorcycle and car vehicle physics. Car control included, motorcycle controller. Ooh, nice. Given that we're going to be getting in cars now, I might be able to use that. Artificial intelligence, zombie AI included. Look, this is pretty much everything we need. Patrol AI included, vehicle AI. Let's go. Well, don't need any motorcycles driving around with no rider. Custom editors, fracture tool, slow motion. Ooh, slow motion system. There's a lot of stuff in this. JUTPS-3. This will be a good place to start. Show Unity. Package Mangler. Importing a complete project will overwrite your current project settings. To leave your project intact, click the switch project button to create a temporary project where you can safely import this package. Now, we haven't really done a lot so far apart from import assets, so we can import this as package manager dependencies. Of course it does. Install. Resolving packages. Lots of installing stuffs. Compiling C-sharp scripts. This project is using the new input system package, but the native platform backends for the new input system are not enabled in the player settings. This means that no input from native devices will come through. Oh, do we have to use the new input system? Okay, if we must. Importing. Reserializing. Import. Okay, so now it's killed Unity because it's restarting it. It's funny, it shows Homeward Hound. We can close that out. I'm not doing that today. Now it's restarting Unity so it can use the new input system. Kind of load with a passion, but I don't know. Use it at some point, I guess. Alright, well, that's loading up. Next step. So we're going to get a JUTPS, which is what we just imported, working on a character to get create sample scene with zombies, create zombie script, test weapons, pick up and drop. Weapons use on zombies. Test fire obligation. vehicle. Entering. Exiting. Cine machine, camera angles, and then all of the notes that we picked up today from the other games. Nerdwino, my fave moon person. How are you, my friend? Good to see you. I was actually just thinking of raiding out. It's been 2.5 hours. We've watched some zombie videos of different zombie games, different zombie third-person shooter games specifically. We've got a whole bunch of notes that we can create the new game from, and a step-by-step of what the next steps are. So we have a zombie in the scene, which we'll need to delete next time because we're working on the player character, not the zombie. What's this Motus man? Was that? Okay, that was just a test character. We can get rid of Motus man. Okay, so I think we're going to call it a day and raid out today. Let me give one quick shout out to Mr. Nerdwino, former NASA scientist, has some amazingly fun space streams with science of the day news, astral photography, also even does Lego building. So definitely get yourself over to Nerdwino if you're not already following. And do so. Come back, Berlin. Good to see you. I'm gonna have a look and see who's on now. See who we can raid out to. Do 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 do. God, what is this music? Something a bit more calm. Okay, let's see who's on. See who we can raid out to today. A bunch of friendos on today. We've got DJ Chisel 69, and I think we've raided out to before a couple of streams ago. Coffee Make Stuff, doing some software and game dev. We also have Yogurt Garrel on, who says, not a real stream, just testing. I think she was having internet issues, so she's testing her connection. Let's see. Let me open up a couple of these windows, make sure that these people are not about to raid out. Worse than raiding into someone and then they just go and raid out to somebody else.
Thanks, Susan Jefferson.
You know, we love eating Little Caesars and watching the Vikings play.
And one day, I'm going to be just like you.
How about right now?
How about no? How about that? Okay. Oh, I didn't see Bean was on. Celestial Bean Art. Let's see what she's doing today. Oh, looks like she's been on for less than an hour. And she has her affiliate-versary. So we can go over there and we can wish her a happy affiliate anniversary. That's okay, you shout all you want, because I've seen lots of beautiful people in here today. Okay, so we're going to head over to the inimitable Celestial Bean Art today. There's an amazing artist. She's the best bean, and she also creates some stuff, some streaming stuff, for people like Science Streams. Just because I was typing out, thanks for the fun times, just because I was typing out my thank you message. Alrighty, so we're going to head on over to the stream ending screen. Oh, and look, the new message is working. It says, see you on Monday, because that'll be the next time I'm streaming. And we'll see if the Fancy Pants raid widget is working today. This channel is intended for mature audiences. So just a heads up, there we go. it's raiding time, and yeah, bit of a Yoda there. So thanks everybody that stopped by today. Thank you for the new follow, for the lurkers, people that watch the fun zombie videos with me. Booyah Grandma, especially for having an amazing game that we watched the trailer for. And I hope everybody has a good weekend. I won't be back on until Monday. As you can see from the Fancy Pants widget, we're about to raid out to Celestial Beanart, show her some love. So stay on the raid train for some extra channel points. And then over the weekend, I'll try and put that automatic title change in place so that when we stream on Mondays and Wednesdays, it says, like it says now for Homeward Hound, but then on Fridays, it says about the zombie stuff. Is it not a raid?
Marsupial.
Oh, okay. We'll have to change that. Okay, so the only raid out text I have is the one that says we were working on Homeward Hound. I'm going to have to come up.